In this video, I will share with you the complete itinerary of my Spiti road trip. I'll try to be descriptive. I'll share the information about where you can stay and the places to visit at different locations. We started off from Chandigarh. Our first stop was going to be Narkanda, but as we started off in the later half of the day, we reached Narkanda by 11 p.m., which is very late, and we were very tired next morning. If you start early in the morning, you can directly go to Chitkum. That would save a day for you. Next day, we traveled from Narkanda to Chitkum. On the way, we had our lunch at Rampur. Rampur is a small town which is a small distance away from Narkanda. So once you reach Chitkul is very beautiful, and in addition to that, this is a major tourism attraction, so there are a lot of places to stay where you can put up. So there are some options, like you have hostel, which is Zostel, then you have some riverside camps, or you can stay at a budget hotel. So you can choose according to your requirement. There's a small town named Raksham right before Chitkul. That is also very beautiful, and it also has a couple of budget hotels where you can stay. While in Chitkul, you must remember that whatever food they serve you, they prepare it instantaneously. So when you order your food, try to order in one go, because if you order partially and later on order for more, this would take a while. While in Chitkul, I will recommend you to go for a morning walk, because in morning, Chitkul is at its scenic best. The beauty of Chitkul kind of grows on you. So the next day, our destination was going to be Nako. We woke up early in the morning, went for a morning walk. After that, we did some sightseeing. If you move ahead of it, Chitkul, and follow that same route, you end up at an army base camp, which is the last place in India. Beyond that army base camp, there is a defense land, and after that, it's the China border. So that's why it's called the last village of India, Chitkul, because after Chitkul, there is no other village in Indian territory. Chinese territory starts from there. So next day, we started from Chitkul, and by nightfall, we reached our destination, which is Nako. Nako is a beautiful small town, but try to make sure that you make the reservations in advance, because there is a lot of rush in Nako during the summer. It gets really hard to find accommodation in those days. In Nako, there is a monastery which you can visit. So the next day, we started at about 9 p.m. We were headed for Gaza, from Nako to Gaza. But on our way, we were to visit Giu village. The Giu village is a very interesting village. It's a small village. It's a little detour from the regular route from Nako to Gaza. But the Giu village is the host to the only natural mummy of India. So there was a monk who mummified himself. So that mummy belongs to him, and it is put in a monastery. Monastery is currently being built there. Actually, it is currently placed in a glass container. You will see those images shortly. And one thing to add, the ride from Nako to Gaza, that's one of the most beautiful rides I had been to before this, because Once I reached Gaza, it only got more beautiful. Yeah, this is the mummy I was talking about. So this is the only natural mummy of India. This monk mummified himself while he was alive. I don't know how much pain he would have to go through to make that happen. So we stayed at that monastery for a bit. It was a spiritual experience for us. And when we tried to leave, then there was a landslide. And the road was blocked for majority of the time in that evening. And that evening at around 6 p.m. we started from Giu and reached Gaza at around 11:30 or 12. We stayed at a hotel there. We had already booked that too. That's why we could reach so late and still be able to find accommodation. Gaza is really beautiful. It's a valley. Spiti is entirely a valley, so it's a part of Spiti Valley, one of the major towns of Spiti Valley. This town is surrounded by snow-covered peaks from all sides. We woke up in the morning, had our lunch, and the next day we started off to the circuit of Langsa, Kibber and Hikkim. Langsa is the small village with big statue of Buddha. Komik is world's highest motorable village. And Hikkim is the place where world's highest post office exists. So this post office is highest post office in the entire world. You can post some postcards to your address from there, and sometimes they reach, sometimes they don't. There is an interesting fact about Komik. In Komik there is a monastery. And in that monastery, they have a stuffed snow leopard. That snow leopard actually died of aging near to the village. So the villagers brought that snow leopard and they stuffed it and placed it in their monastery. It's actually these three villages are at the top of the mountain, but the mountain top is rather flattened, and they have fields there. They plow their fields, they make whatever wheat they can for themselves. They have some animals from which they get milk and wool. And after coming down from Hikkim, next thing we went to was the Ki Monastery. Ki Monastery is an iconic monastery. It's one of the most beautiful monasteries. And after Ki Monastery, that night we reached Kibber and we stayed there. So in Kibber, I would suggest you to take a homestay. There are mostly homestays in Kibber, and the people are really great and loving in their nature, and they are very welcoming nature. And at homestay, they actually make you feel like you are staying at a home. It doesn't feel like it's professional, although it is professional. So the next day, we headed towards Kunzum Pass via Shisham Bridge. On the way, there is a small town, Losar. Losar is a small town in Himalayas, towards the end of Spiti, actually. And this town is a beautiful small town where you won't get much to see. but the beauty, the scenery, that's so beautiful and breathtaking. After that, we went all the way to the Kunzum top. Our plan was to go to Chandratal Lake and come back from Manali side, but since the road hadn't opened because of heavy snowfall, we had to be content with going to the Kunzum top and coming back. At Kunzum top, there was a guy who got too excited and he drove his Thar right into mud and his Thar got stuck. And that stuck Thar had to stay there overnight, and towards the end of the day, there was a heavy snowfall. So we can just imagine how that would have ended for the Thar. So after that, we started coming back from the Kunzum top, and we started heading back towards Kibber. We stayed the night at Kibber. That's me just trying to capture the beauty of that place, although I might not have done justice to the beauty, but I tried to capture as much as I could. So when you are in Spiti, I would recommend you to really go for the Hikkim Langsa comic circuit and Kunzum and Loser. Why Shishim Bridge? Because Shishim Bridge is a beauty in itself. It's the highest altitude bridge in, I think, entire Asia, if I'm not wrong. And the beauty of this place is totally different from what you would have seen at other places. This is something divine, I think. Next day, we started heading back towards Nako. On our way, we visited Dhanka Monastery. That's the end. Thank you for watching.